Welcome to Week 11 of Football Fridays in Georgia here on Georgia Public Broadcasting. Tonight, we're in Clarkson, Georgia at Hallford Stadium, where the undefeated and top-ranked Tucker Tigers will take on their region rivals, the Lions of MLK.
And we'll be catching some senior night spirit as we talk to some of the graduating players from Tucker. Plus, we'll be mixing in a little politics with our sports tonight as we catch up with a local lawmaker.
Put that remote down. Don't go anywhere because me and my main man, Trey, going to come at you with a little extra point with our talk.
Yeah, there's top players up and down these two rosters. Don't go anywhere. That's coming up after this.
So it's the Tucker Tigers. It's the Lions of ML King. It's a big region rivalry. The All Access Pass pregame show is coming your way next, live on GPB. Hi again, everyone, and welcome to Football Fridays in Georgia's All Access Pass. Tonight, a big region rivalry as the Tucker Tigers, unbeaten and ranked number one, take on the Lions of Martin Luther King.
Tonight, we are back at Hallford Stadium where the skies have cleared. It is a beautiful night for football in Georgia.
It is a great night for football. This is a big game, two interesting styles. MLK loves to throw it. Tucker likes to grind it out on the ground.
And we'll see who comes out on top. This is a huge game for both teams, and we've been hearing from these teams all week long on social media, whether it's Facebook, Twitter, maybe even Pinterest. I don't know. Let's check in with our social media correspondent, Grace Olson. Hey, Grace.
Hey, Claire. That's right. Tonight, we've got an epic battle between the Lions and the Tigers here at Hallford Stadium, and for a game like this, you just can't keep your thoughts to yourself. That's what makes social media and sports such a great pair. GPB Sports has it going on Instagram, on Facebook, and on Twitter. Now, Tucker is having a pregame ceremony right now honoring their seniors who have worked so hard these past 4 years. So I thought I'd tweet them this week and find out what some of their favorite memories have been as high school football players. Star outside linebacker and UJ commit Dietrich Dukes told me that his favorite memory is winning the state title his sophomore year. I've got a photo for this next one. Tucker outside linebacker Jamal Paxton said going to the playoffs and beating Stevenson have been two of his favorite memories. Here's a photo of the Tigers running that ball down the field. Now receiver Jalen Pearson tweeted his favorite memory as a high school athlete came in 2011 when his team was on the road to winning state. They had to beat Northside Warner Robins. They beat them in the last second, and then they ended up going to the Dome and beating Lovejoy 22-7. Here's a photo of those kids hoisting the trophy at the Dome. They were so excited. Jalen says that's exactly why he's working so hard this year so those younger players can feel that same feeling. Now I'll keep those stories coming all night long on Twitter. Also like us on Facebook, be one of the thousands that have liked us, and we'll keep you updated on the road to the Dome. Make sure to download the GPB football app. Now is the time to do that. You need to stay updated on scores with things winding down, the playoffs coming up, and the road to the Dome on its way. Mark and Claire, I know you can attest to how important that app is.
It's very important, especially this time of year with the playoffs lurking, and it's free, so that's a good thing.
That is huge. That's great. You know, Tucker is undefeated right now and trying to hold on to that undefeated record as they head into the playoffs. And one of the big reasons, or one of the big things they have to do every week, is make sure that they have a routine. And for Tucker, part of that routine is their pregame meal. It's a busy Friday inside Matthew's cafeteria in Tucker.
I want you to bread a little bit more chicken.
And Michael Matthews Green is getting ready for one of the biggest meals his family's restaurant will serve all week.
Every Friday night for the number one ranked team in the state, Tucker Tigers.
150 players, coaches, and cheerleaders walk the few blocks from Tucker High School here to the restaurant located on Main Street since 1955.
I don't know many places that still have the high school at the end of Main Street, and all the players and cheerleaders come eat pregame meal. It's really impressive.
Matthews has an extensive menu, but for the Tigers, there's only one meal that'll do.
Sports people are superstitious, me included. If they lose, which they haven't done this year, then we'll go to something else.
You'll change the menu.
But as long as they win, they get fried chicken, mashed potatoes, and green beans.
Wow.
Yeah.
And down in the kitchen, Green says it takes a lot of ingredients to cook up a winning pregame meal.
I'd say for 150 people, maybe 40 pounds of boiled potatoes, peeled potatoes. We got some right
here. Right
there,
yeah.
The same amount of green beans, I would say, maybe 40 pounds or so. And
150 rolls. So
That's a lot of food.
But for this Tucker football alum, it's just another way he and Matthew's Cafeteria give back to the community that walks through these doors each day.
It kind of keeps you young in a way, you know. It kind of I feel like I'm, like I could still play tomorrow if I had to suit up, you know.
Although Michael did tell me he doesn't think he would make the Tucker team of today. They have been absolutely phenomenal in recent years, winning state titles in 2008 and 2011. They say a big part of that was that special pregame meal. Mark?
Well, you are what you eat, you know, so they're eat like champions. It's a big, big region game here. Tucker's had a great stretch. They won two state championships in the last 6 years. MLK is loaded with talent as well. So let's toss it over to the two guys who are going to call tonight's game, Keelan Johnson and Trey McDaniel, for a little chalk talk in a segment we call Extra Point. Guys?
Thank you very much, Mark. We all know that DeKalb County has been a talent hotbed over the last few years. Both tonight's teams certainly fit that bill. We're going to take you through a couple of players to watch for each team.
Well, first and foremost, Trey, in Southwest DeKalb's have put 493 players to the Division I football level. That's immaculate, Trey. But I'm going to talk about a few guys on Tucker's team that I really think that's going to go on to the next level and do some great things. Dominic Sanders, okay? Get his name out there. Dominic Sanders brings a lot to the table, okay? This guy plays free safety. He plays cornerback. He's even actually the punter out there, and he's the punt returner. So this guy's like Superman on the football field. This is my guy for me, okay? Second guy I have, Yaquise, okay? Sheely. All right? He returns kicks. He's very active. He's a really good defensive back. He's going to go on to the next level. Have not committed anywhere yet, but keep your eye on that guy. A couple honorary mention guys, Thomas Brown, Asher Allen, and Jabari Davis went to Tennessee too as well. These guys, nothing but rich tradition right here, full of talent, Trey.
That's great stuff, Keelan. MLK has no shortage of talent as well. Let's start with their best guy. It's cornerback Wes Green. Now, this guy has 25 college offers. He was committed to South Carolina just this week, Keelan. He opened up his commitment again. Mm-hmm. He's wide open. Anybody can have him. George's in the mix. He's a shutdown corner, probably their best player. You'll see him on Saturdays next year. Another guy to look for is defensive end Arden Key. Arden Key is just a junior. He's going to be one of those guys that we talk about next year who we're all waiting to find out who he commits to. He is a big-time football player. He's going to be a great player tonight, but next year will really be the key for Arden Key. Yes. Let's also talk about their strong safety, Shaka Diarasuba. Hard to pronounce, but he'll make his name known tonight. He's a big hitter and the leader back there on defense. Now, although we've only given you five guys, there's probably 55 guys between these two teams that'll go on to play football at the next level. Tune in for kickoff to find out which one of these guys will have the most impact on tonight's game. Mark, Claire?
I love these guys. You know, Chalk Talk, they've got all the X's and O's.
They really do. And you know what's amazing is they were talking about how many of these players we're going to be seeing on Saturdays in the future. The great news is you don't have to wait too long to see them tonight.
That's right, just a few minutes away. Coming up on the All Access Pass pregame show, I talked earlier today with Tucker head coach Brian Lamar. He's posted an 18-3 record in just a little over a season and a half.
Plus, we'll find out which high school players have gone on to greener pastures of pro football. That and much more as Football Fridays in Georgia's All Access Pass continues here on GPB.
Football Fridays in Georgia on GPB is made possible in part by Regions Bank, it's time to expect more. Georgia's Electric Membership Corporation, lighting the way. Technical College System of Georgia, learn more, earn more. And by viewers like you, thank you.
This is you. You're a Georgia high school student, full of fresh ideas and a desire to make a difference in your school and community. Well, now's your chance. GPB wants you to help stop the drop by showing us why it's important to stay in school. Grab a camera, maybe a friend or two, and create a 30-second video PSA. Why do your peers drop out? What's a solution? All ideas are welcome. Check out the full details at gpb.org/stopthedrop and get going.
Football Fridays in Georgia is live every Friday on GPB during football season, and you never know who you're going to run into. Sometimes it's a very famous comedian who thinks you might be a redneck. I've interviewed Jeff Foxworthy before, but this was one of those rare times when I got to interview him as a dad. His daughter was homecoming queen.
I'm thrilled for her tonight. This is her night.
And I also got to tell everyone what Jeff's middle name is. I cannot wait for this season of Football Fridays. Go online and let us know some of your favorite moments.
One of the most important musicians of the 20th century. Jimi Hendrix revolutionized the electric guitar.
Not only a guitar player, he was a showman too.
A black man fronting a rock band. It just didn't happen before.
You gotta get Jimi Hendrix.
Look for Jimi Hendrix. From the Emmy-winning American Masters. Tuesday at 9 on GPB.
GPB, winner of 15 Emmy Awards. Thank you for your support.
Welcome back to our GPB All Access Pass pregame show as we get ready for the undefeated and top-ranked Tucker Tigers to collide with the Lions of ML King. The Tucker Tigers are on a roll. They are unbeaten. They are ranked number one in 5A. They've won two state championships in the past 6 years. And earlier today, it is senior night, by the way, and earlier today I talked to head coach Brian Lamar and his outstanding defensive back, Kirk Tucker. Coach, it's senior night tonight here at Hallford Stadium. Talk about what this group of seniors has meant to you and your program.
It's a great group. They've accomplished a lot and still have a lot they would like to accomplish. We're chasing their third region championship in 4 years, and of course they got a state championship under their belt and two trips to the semifinals and three trips to the quarterfinals under their belt already. So it's a great group of guys that work extremely hard, great leadership, and so hopefully we can finish this thing out.
All right, Kirk, you are a senior, so it's your senior night. What's it going to be like for you to take the field here this evening?
It's going to be great, just like every other game. Coach always says it's a big game because it's the next game, and we're going to treat it like that. You know, when we went against Stevenson, we weren't as, you know, sound and set. So this game, we're really going to be cut down on penalties and really show how disciplined we are.
You've already made a commitment to where you're going to play next year at the collegiate level. Tell us why you decided to be a Stanford Cardinal.
Well, you know, a lot of people ask me why I didn't go to the SEC or, you know, ACC. I'm looking at more than football. I'm looking at life. So, you know, Stanford and the degree that I will attain there, I just want to, you know, have that kind of thing under my belt and play football out there in California.
And there's another Tucker Tiger, James Waters, out there who's playing very well this year.
Oh, yes, sir. James, every time I go there, you know, he always escorts me and he helps me out there. So he always shows me a great time.
Well, you've got the perfect name for the Tucker Tigers, Kirk Tucker. So you're right there.
Oh, yes, sir, definitely.
Okay. Now, Coach, you are a former Tucker Tiger. Talk a little bit about flashing back to when your playing days and your senior night.
It was a big night. I remember it. You know, we got a good win against the Clarkson Angores. Back then they were pretty stout, and so you know, it was a good night. It's the same type of stuff, man. We got you know, Tucker kids are Tucker kids, and it seemed like the same guys I play with are the same guys that I'm coaching. You know, guys that's going to play hard, and great guys, great character people on and off the field, and so it's just been a joy to come back home and coach these guys.
Not many guys get to coach at their alma mater. Congratulations and good luck tonight against ML King.
Thank you.
And Brian Lamar's 18-3 in just a season and a half as head coach of the Tucker Tigers. Now let's send it over to Claire Sims, who has a very special guest alongside.
Thank you so much, Mark. I am here with someone we usually find down at the state capitol. This is Senator Steve Henson of Tucker. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
Now, you grew up here, so you know what Tucker Tiger football is all about.
Oh, it's crazy. They're really excited. This 8-0 season's turned on a lot of people. I went to Henderson High School. We were a rival back then, but it's a middle school now, so I now have to root for the Tucker.
And you were an athlete in high school.
Well, I wrestled and I lettered. That's all I'm claiming, but I enjoyed it. It's good for the young people to be involved in sports. It helps them in a lot of ways.
And you have a special project that you're working on in that vein.
Yeah, I'm chairman of the American Association of Adapted Sports Board. It's a nonprofit that helps young people who have disabilities participate in sports in schools. So it's great to see young people getting those kind of life skills that they can get in sports, competing, improving their physical conditions, even if they're in wheelchairs. We do wheelchair basketball and other wheelchair sports. It's a great program, really, really am excited about it.
And because there aren't a lot of schools that can offer those programs.
You know, it's tough to do if you're starting from scratch. This program goes in, teaches coaches, teaches referees, and assists the school systems in providing these things. And it's common here in Metro. But when you get some of the rural counties, we need to reach out more and get more kids involved.
All right. Now, this is technically your off season. The legislature doesn't start back up until January. Any other big projects you're working on?
Well, as always, we're getting ready for the session. There's a lot of talk of cities. There's, always talks on taxes. And in DeKalb and Gwinnett, we have different issues with the county governments that we're working on. So, it's a crunch time now before session starts.
All right. Thank you so much for being here tonight.
Thank you. I really appreciate it.
And we'll say good luck to your Tucker Tigers, even though you're an honorary Tucker Tiger.
I hope MLK does great. I hope Tucker does great. I'm rooting for everybody.
All right. Thank you again.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Mark?
I love those politicians who root for everybody. They're clever, very clever. You know, when you think about the sheer number of players that play high school football, it is definitely worth bragging about when some of them make it to the professional level. It's really super.
It is. And, you know, every week we talk about some of these kids. Claim to fame is what we call it. But there's usually maybe one or two. But Tucker, they are off the charts. John Nelson is joining us to talk about that.
I've had to use both hands, I think, for this one. And I think it's seven and counting is what we came up with.
You're going to run out of fingers and toes.
Well, yeah. Let's see. I can take my shoe off if you want.
Please don't.
Well, let's start off in 2008 class. Nico Thorpe.
Nico Thorpe went from Tucker to Auburn, and he played on the Plains. I have a bit of an update on Nico. You see down there at the bottom with the Toronto Argonauts a couple of weeks ago. It was a serious injury on the field at Skydome in Toronto. They thought that something might have been wrong with his neck, but he came out healthy. Everything's cool with Nico, and it's good to see him up in the CFL these days.
And next up, Dwayne Harris, Tucker class of 2006.
Going back 2 years, so that would mean that this was when Nico was a sophomore. Dwayne Harris from 2006 made his way to East Carolina to catch up with the Pirates out there, had a cup of coffee with the Dallas Cowboys.
How about Brandon Lang, Tucker class of 2005.
Big Brandon Lang, 6'5", 6'6", tight end. He was about 250 pounds. He played tight end, a little defensive end as well. Went from there to be with Larry Blakeney at Troy and had a cup of coffee with the Chargers, and he wore the green and gold of the double E in Edmonton.
And a name I am very familiar with as a Georgia Bulldog fan, Asher Allen.
See, this is what we call burying the lead when it comes to this particular segment. Asher Allen, you see down there with the Minnesota Vikings, one of the coolest moments on the national game of the week. I want to say it was on Sunday Night Football when Minnesota was playing on the Peacock Network, where you're supposed to say, okay, I'm so-and-so and you're college. Asher went a step back and he goes, Asher Allen, Tucker High School. And I thought that was really cool.
Well, you know what they called him when I used to cover him when he was at the University of Georgia was the mayor. He knew everybody and everybody knew Asher Allen.
You know, a lot of those football players are like that, though, especially on campus. They really act as sort of ambassadors. And so I feel like a lot of them, you know, it's a great experience for them. They get to do that.
And you also mentioned guys like Patrick Pass, who won a lot of Super Bowl rings with the New England Patriots, John McMacken, who played with the Steelers. And Tucker has a tremendous history of high school football here in the state of Georgia.
And let's not forget, ML King is just a new school, 2006. Right. They're going to have guys in the NFL.
Anticipate in the near future guys going from the second to the third level, so it's going to be really nice to see some Lions in future years.
All right, so some of the guys we see out there tonight.
Oh, yeah.
Six, 7 years from now, they could be in the
NFL. You'll be buying their jersey.
Bank on it.
I'll be looking good. All right, coming up on the All Access Pass, this guy, he's going to come back. John Nelson's
I'm
back with
leaving.
John Georgia. He's got a segment on a championship coach who is retiring soon.
And we continue our Stop the Drop campaign and tell you about the way you could win $1,000. Not bad. That and much more as Football Fridays and Georgia's All Access Pass continues on GPB.
Are you willing to give a helping hand? If you're a Georgia high school student, you can enter GPB's video contest, win $1,000, and make a difference. How can you help stop the drop?
One of my favorite moments from Football Fridays in Georgia is meeting unsung heroes like Caitlin Wilshire. Caitlin is a member of the Southwest DeKalb Marching Band, and she plays the trumpet. And did I mention she's been in a wheelchair since birth? But nothing can stop her. Nothing can even slow her down.
When you go out there, do your whole show, do it right, it feels like you accomplished something.
Meeting her was one of my favorite moments from last year's Football Fridays in Georgia. Log on to GPB Sports Facebook page and tell us about your favorite moments.
On Nova, what's the secret to a safer world?
How about cars that drive themselves?
So I'm not doing anything right now.
What a smart little car.
Or new recipes for fighting fires.
We got something better than water.
Cornstarch.
Even bomb detecting plants?
There you go. You
All
got
right.
them in.
I've done it. So this plant can sniff bombs now?
New discoveries, making stuff safer.
On Why Wednesday at 9, only on GPB.
Each week, GPB brings you the latest in high school sports.
Hi again, everybody.
But we want to hear what you have to say. Tell us what's going on with your team. Share your favorite moments. Post your own pictures and videos. And let everyone know why your team will go all the way. Just log on and like us on Facebook, where you can post comments, pictures, and videos to earn your own team bragging rights. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter, too.
National Anthem. We're getting ready for the Tucker Tigers, unbeaten 8-0, to take on the 6-2 MLK Lions. It's going to be a great Region 6-5A game. Now, John Nelson has covered high school football in the state of Georgia for 20 years. He's written two books on that very subject, and he's our know-it-all, but we want to know if he really does know it all. So this is a segment we call Stump Nelly.
Okay. So I felt last week wearing that hat, it was almost like a hazing because it was a new segment or
something. Well, we're going to see. I have a hermetically sealed envelope right here.
I bet you do.
And we're going to open this thing up.
Yes.
Blow into it. See if we can open it.
You're getting the blow into the envelope a little better now.
I think Johnny Carson was a little bit better at that.
Yes, he was.
And the question this week is.
He was much better at the envelope than you were.
There are at least six teams across Georgia with the team name, the Purple Hurricanes. Which one of these teams does not go by the nickname Purple Hurricanes? Is it A, Cartersville High?
No.
Is it B, Dasher High? Is it C, Fitzgerald High? Or D, Monroe High?
Okay. See, now, this is a bit of a trick question because Fitzgerald technically is singular. It is Purple Hurricane. And Monroe area is Purple Hurricanes. Now, do we include Dasher High as well? I'm just going to go C because it's Purple Hurricane singular. Because
you're thinking way too deep. But you know more than the average guy, that is for
Dasher,
sure.
Dasher, okay.
Dasher High,
All
yes.
Right.
Purple Hurricane.
I file that one. I'm filing that one under protest.
Okay. We'll see you in just a second.
I'm
if you at
moving.
Home have a question to Stump Nelly, just get us on Facebook, get us on Twitter,
yes.
And we'll get your question on
the
air.
Facebook page and the Twitter, yes.
All right, thank you. We'll see you in just a little bit.
Yes.
One of our missions here at GPB is to raise awareness about the low dropout or the high dropout rate in Georgia high schools. It's very important to stay in school and get that degree. For more on our Stop the Drop campaign, let's send it over to Claire.
Thank you so much, Mark. I would like to welcome in a special guest. This is Kami Olatunden. How'd I do?
Good.
All
perfect.
Right, good.
Yay.
We've been practicing. She is the Scholar Support Program Manager and Public Relations Liaison with Project Grad Atlanta. Thank you for being here.
No problem. Honored to be here.
Now, tell me about Project Grad Atlanta. What is that?
Project Grad Atlanta is a nonprofit organization, and our mission is to increase high school graduation rates and college graduation rates for students within the Atlanta public schools.
All right. So who primarily are you working with, and how do you identify those students who need your help?
Well, we actually work with students who are within our Atlanta public schools. We're actually in 16 schools on 7 different campuses within APS. So we work with all the students in those schools to increase those graduation rates.
And what specifically do you guys offer? Is it tutoring or test assistance? What is it?
It's a holistic approach. So we offer tutoring. We do standardized test preparation, so SAT and ACT prep. We do academic summer enrichment programs on the local college campuses, both residential and commuter. And we also support them in college when they receive our scholarship. So it's a holistic approach to make sure that those graduation rates are increasing.
So obviously you guys work with a lot of students. Do you have any special success stories that you like to share?
Absolutely. We have one student, and he always touches our heart. He's like our poster child. But he actually is the first of his family to actually go to college and the first of his siblings to even finish middle school. And now he's a graduate of Morehouse College.
Wow.
So we're so excited about that. And actually, he used our writing lab to help get him entrance into Morehouse College. So we're so excited about that and his success.
Wow, thank you so much. If somebody would like to get some more information about your program, what should they do?
They should go to our website, and our website is www.projectgradatlanta.org.
All right, thank you so much for being here, Cammie.
Thank you
so much. We appreciate it. Thank you for the hard work you do.
Absolutely.
GPB's Stomp the Drop campaign aims to improve graduation rates across Georgia. Time's running out to enter this year's video contest. High school students across the state can still take part by creating a 30-second video PSA. That PSA should tackle the issue of why some kids drop out of school and offer encouragement to at-risk students. So for full details, just go to gpb.org/stopthedrop, and you'll be able to vote online for your favorite video, which we will reveal during the championships in December. And if your video is the winning video, you will take home a pretty nice $1,000. So for more information, just visit us at gpb.org/stopthedrop. Mark?
Thanks, Claire. We now re-welcome back into the program John Nelson, a guy who's written four books, two on high school football in the great state of Georgia, a segment we call John's Georgia, brought to you by
Georgia's EMC.
Topic number one, an outstanding championship coach is hanging up his whistle.
Cecil Flo, Parkview High. You look at Cecil, we're going to spend some time in Jackson, Sonny, and Walton EMCs for this one. After 21 years, Cecil Flo's hanging him up. Take you back to 2002. It was Brookwood and Parkview with a battle of Five Forks stricken for the championship. Sean Dawkins plows into somebody in the end zone on the touchdown. You see the guy in the white hat? Guess who it was? Number 13 himself, Jeff Francoeur. That made it 14-0. You're going to see a screen pass here to Joey Sturdivant for the touchdown. 28-7 win. Four titles in 6 years, 97, 2000, 2001, 2002. They beat Brookwood there 28-7. So it's sad to see Cecil Flo go, a great ambassador for high school sports in Georgia. That's topic one. What's topic two?
All right, topic two, an undefeated team in class single A.
The continuing adventures of Marion County. And for that, Flint Energy's Diverse Power, Sony EMC as well. We'll take you back to last Friday night, Marion County and Brookstone in Region 4 single A. And the highlights, it was all Marion County. And guess who got faked out? Our good buddy Dave Plata here from WTVM-TV in Columbus. Dustin Eckert, everyone thought he was handing the ball off to Johnny Royal. Eckert goes 49 yards, but then Royal comes right up the middle for the touchdown. 39-14 the final, and there's a reason Marion County is at the top of the power rankings in single-A public, and that's your last example of that last Friday night. That's it for topic two. What's topic three?
Some great action in class 4A in the Savannah area.
And we're going to spend time in four separate places. It's Canucci, Coastal Energy Cooperative, Okefenokee, and Satilla EMCs for Wayne County and Liberty County. Liberty County, remember, has Raekwon McMillan, one of the top recruits in the country. Special teams problems early on for Liberty, but they can't quite capitalize. They were down, and believe it or not, the Jackets never trailed in this game. The touchdown pass right there by Liberty. Malik Jackson goes 10 of 16 for 157 yards and a score. Nine carries, 66 yards and a score. 34-26 your final. 7-1 plays 8-0 Statesboro tonight.
All right, that's this week's edition of John's Georgia, brought to you by
Georgia's EMC.
All right, Claire.
We are just moments away from kickoff, so let's check in one last time with our social media correspondent, Grace Olson. Hey, Grace.
Thanks, Claire. And I told you earlier that the best way to supplement watching tonight's game on TV is to follow GPB Sports on Twitter and on Facebook. I'll keep you up to date with all the behind-the-scenes action from tonight's game if you follow us on Twitter and like us on Facebook. Now, I found this graphic tweeted by a ton of Tucker fans this week. We all know the phrase, keep calm and carry on, but this week they're saying, keep calm, number one ranked team in the state, returns next week. Hashtag Tuck Nation. Now, Tucker's calling it Tuck Nation, but MLK, they're calling it Lion Nation. So we'll see whose nation it really is tonight as this game ensues. Now, I told you earlier about the GPB football app and how helpful it is. I know how important it is to you guys to stay up to date from scores from around the state. And there's no better way to do it than with GPB's app. I'm going to show you right here. You download the app from the App Store. And did I mention it's free? Just click on games and you can choose the game you want, find the score you need to see, and stay up to date. So I'm going to send it back over to Mark and Claire on the set.
All right, thanks, Grace. It is finally that time, Mark.
It's the time we've all been waiting for, and I'm pretty pumped out about all this.
I mean, this is going to be a fabulous game. If you are watching right now at home, do not get off the couch. You better have your snacks, your drinks, everything handy, because you are not going to want to go anywhere throughout this game.
And I'm really anxious to see this game because it's two different styles. One team likes to pass, one team likes to run. They both have good defenses.
It's going to be a really great game. Lions, Tigers, and GPB. Oh, my.
All right. It is time for the Lions of MLK, for the Tucker Tigers. It is game time on GPB.
Live on GPB.
Exactly 100 years ago, November 1st, 1913, a pivotal event occurred in the history of American football. During a game against Army, the quarterback for the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame started throwing forward passes to a receiver named Newt Rockne. 14 of 17 passes were completed for a total of 243 yards, three touchdowns, and a surprise 35-13 win over Army at West Point.
Some players had tried forward passes before, but this game 100 years ago proved they were much more than a one-off gimmick. Football has evolved in many ways since November 1st, 1913. The pads are bigger, the helmets harder, the competition tougher. This year they don't come much tougher than the Tucker Tigers, as some of this year's earlier opponents can attest. In most of their games this season, the Tigers have won with at least 50 points on the scoreboard. Head coach Brian Lamar played on this very team not so many years ago. He's a Tiger to the bone. Let's just say that if Tucker doesn't get to the playoffs, it might be a sign of the apocalypse. But the MLK Lions of Lithonia have plenty to roar about as well. They were undefeated last season up to the second playoff round, and that includes beating Tucker. Can they do it again this year? They have a new coach, Cortez Allen, and they also have a taste for playing at the championship level. One more thing about Newt Rockne. He once said it isn't necessary to see a good tackle, you can hear it. We're all ears tonight at Halford Stadium with Lions and Tigers and Pigskin, oh my. It's Football Fridays in Georgia. Live on GPB.